We're going through the roses and cutting off our roses for the aged care facilities and frontline workers, and yeah, just to say thank you. People had a tough year. It's something we've never done before, so it's unprecedented to cut off our roses. And some lovely ladies coming from the local Flemington Rotary to come and bunch them up and put them all into buckets and wrap ribbons around them and distribute them for us.
We've been preparing the roses to go out to the community and the frontline workers that have done so much for our community, and that's how we've got through. I just thought it's a great project, and it's the thought behind. We all love someone to think about us, and there's a lot of people out there that don't have that generally. This is great for them.
Well, never before have the famous Flemington roses been so important. With no crowds here, they well and truly have taken centre stage. And the man in charge of the roses, the keeper of the roses, joins us now. Welcome, Mick Ryan. Congratulations. I know not many people have been able to be here to appreciate them. It looks spectacular. Maybe take us through, how many roses do you have here, Mick, at Flemington?
Thanks for the lovely words. We have 16,000 roses, just over a touch of 16,000 roses, and generally we change around 1,000 of them each year just to keep it fresh and new.
Well, the awesome thing, Georgie, is the way that they've left no stone unturned, and despite the fact there's no one here, they've gone full out to make it look magnificent. Have you checked it out on our broadcast to make sure it's all looking right?
I'm pretty happy with the broadcast. I love the mounting yard shot with Michael in the mounting yard. So even I had to cut a couple of roses away for him the other day because they're in the way. But
well, he's a little bit precious too, isn't he? He doesn't like it when someone else takes centre stage.
Yeah,
right. They look spectacular. I mean, Quarters and I are hack gardeners, but the way that you get them, Mick, to bloom so early and so beautifully, I mean, what's the secret to a beautiful rose here at Flemington? Is it a special fertiliser?
Well, we use Sudden Impact for roses on our roses, but the secret is the pruning, the timing, and your pruning, and how much love you give to them. The more love you give to them, the more they give you back.
What do you mean by that, though? What's
plenty of food and plenty of water.
Right.
Plenty of food, plenty of water, and good pruning.
How many staff do you have to get the place looking so spectacular?
There's 20 gardeners in total. I could do with more. That's a very hard project, but yeah, that's 20 of us in total.
Now, my colleague here, Stephen Quatermain, we were doing a rehearsal before Derby, Mick, and we were walking along and I said, aren't the flowers just magnificent? And he casually whispered in my ear and said, actually, mine are might have better than
this. Oh, I did not say that.
I tell you, not a lie, he said that to me. So we've got some vision of his roses that we thought we'd put up to see what they're like. Now, hang on.
Oh, that's a stitcher.
This is from your place. Mick can give us an assessment. I would argue that he is completely off track there.
I agree. Georgie, I agree. That hurts.
What is he? He needs to work on his game, doesn't he?
He needs some water.
His rose game. In fairness, I think we have a little bit more vision of your wonderful roses. Oh, look, they're a bit there. What do you think
better.
Of those, Mick?
They're all enough.
I reckon they're photos of here.
No, they are fair dinkum from my garden, but I agree, it is water and my dad tells me to prune just before spring starts, leave it late, and I've got new fertiliser, which has worked a treat.
Good man, we start pruning late April.
Late April?
Yeah,
really?
We start pruning late April, the slow ones.
But doesn't the cold affect the...
No, they need their cold, they need their dormancy.
Oh,
that's the secret.
We need this.
I'm the only person in Melbourne that loves a really cold winter, because they do need a break.
And okay. Favourite rose, mine's a Pierre de Ronsard. Mick, what's your favourite?
Pierre de Ronsard.
Oh, look at that. See, I've already got more in common than you have, Gordon.
My favourite rose would be the English.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And I do like an iceberg. You've got lots of icebergs here. And, of course, all these beautiful roses are going to some of our frontline healthcare workers, which is such a gorgeous gesture that they're not wasted.
Yeah, it's a lovely gesture. The locals, Rotary Group, do a great job in bunching up the gardeners, cut them all for them. We've started that. We already... 155 bunches of roses, I think, or more, have gone out, and we've got more to do on Monday. So, yeah, looking forward to that. It's a great initiative.
Congratulations.
Well done, Mick.
Thank you, guys.